And you will give him the charge and then pray the prayer and then the right hand of fellowship. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay.
In 1 Timothy chapter 3, verse 8, it says, likewise must the deacons be great, not double-tongued, not given too much wine, and greedy and filthy lucre, holding the mystery of faith and a pure conscience. And let those also first be proven, then let them use the office of a deacon, being found blameless. Even so must the wise be grave, not slander, sober, faithful in all things. Let the deacons be the husband of one wife, ruling their children and their own houses well. For they that have used the office of a deacon well, purchase to themselves a good degree and great boldness in the faith which is in Jesus Christ.
And now you will turn around and kneel right here at an altar, and everybody that would, and especially your wife, if you would tell.
Yes.
And we're going to pray the prayer of consecration. Every ordained, you're pleased to come forward. And Larry, are you leading this prayer?
Earl,
you lead the prayer, my brother.
Heavenly Father, we want to thank you, Lord, for this opportunity that we have to mourn a brother, Lord, in your eyes of glory.
Yes, Lord.
We'd ask, Father, that you would be with him, Lord. Lead, direct, and guide him in every one of his footsteps, Father. And to fill his mouth, Father, with thy word. Father, we ask, Lord, that you allow your word to come out of his mouth, Father, that he would be a leader, Father, as you have him to be. Bless his heart, Father, in mighty ways. Bless his wife. Bless his family, Father, that he can do thy work for us when he not have done. Father, we ask each and everything in the name of Jesus Christ. And amen.
Amen. You might stand up and turn around there, and Brother Larry will do the right hand of fellowship. And everybody, after Larry's done, can come and do this, if you would. Give him the right hand of fellowship.
Brother Jim, my pleasure to welcome you into the conference as an ordained deacon. Hope for a blessing to you and your blessing to us. And we ask you just to be a blessing to your pastor and be a blessing to your church. And most of all, let the Lord lead and guide your footsteps and you'll be just fine.
Everybody just come on right around. Give him the right hand of fellowship. Come on, church.
I heard an old story. How my Savior came from glory, how he gave his life on Calvary to save a wretch like me. I heard about his glory, of his precious blood atoning, ended of my sin, the victory. Oh, victory in Jesus, my Savior forever. He sought me and he bought me with his redeeming blood. He loved me and he plunged me to victory beneath the cleansing blood. I've heard about his victory, of his crimson power reducing. And then I cried, dear Jesus, come and heal my broken spirit. And somehow Jesus came and brought to me the victory.
Let the church sing.
Oh, victory in Jesus, my Savior forever. He sought me and he bought me